A lot of me cutting out of my video game things is me too, like where I'll be like playing and like and I'll stop and vape and drink something. And then I'll go kids have to go through, find all this, and cut it out. Literally did she know we were recording the entire time?
Hi everybody, it's me Heavenly and I'm here. I cannot. Okay. Anyways, I'm here with Susie Spector, which is Spector Vlogs on YouTube, and her and I have a little bit of history, okay? Not like that, you
good
freak.
History.
Anyways, good history.
Oh, wait.
Good, like... No.
Like, did you really have to think about that for a second?
Anyway, so we're both entertainers here in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and she does some amazing stuff and everything. Of course, if you guys have seen my stuff, then you already know that she is... Oh, she's amazing and everything. So we are doing some stuff back and forth from my channel to her channel. So all the links will be down in the description. Make sure to go and check those out and everything. So anywho, ladies and gentlemen, Susie Spector.
Hi. So, hi, internets. How are you? I'm gothic and scary and attractive. No, I'm just kidding. I'm sorry.
Sorry. As you can tell, the sense of humor is very canny and everything. But no, I'm going to be taking and interviewing her for you guys today on my channel. So that way you guys will get to know her and check her out on her channel and everything, because she is absolutely an amazing person. Okay, so my very first question for you is, what is the most awkward thing that's ever happened to you on stage?
Oh my God, okay.
Yeah, let's start this thing off for real, okay?
So I have danced in a room with one person and I have danced in front of 30,000 people. And one of those times, probably one of the biggest shows I've ever done in my life, was at a festival called Amphi Festival. It's a gothic industrial festival. It's been going on a long time. It was in Germany. Everyone there was so gorgeous. You would have exploded. You would have exploded the people that were there. I mean, 30,000 people, they are all dressed to the hilt, leather, and I don't know if you've ever heard of Adora Batbrat or people like that. They're all there. And I was dancing with a band. There are drones, like literally flying in the air with cameras and stuff on me. And I was like, I was terrified right before I got on stage. And I was like checking myself. I'm like, all right, it's gonna be a great show. You know, I'm like amping myself up. I'm like, I'm gonna do it. It's gonna be great. Well, I'm really excited. And the first song, I'm like, yeah, I'm hitting it. And I'm doing some German Ruhr dancing, which if you've ever like seen those videos people make fun of where they're like, goth kids dance to anything and they're doing that weird like punching and stuff. It's called Ruhr dancing. And I was doing that and I was getting it, I was like, yeah, yeah. And then I realized I felt something tap my arm. And when I looked back, my top on one side had, and I was literally in front of this entire, like the sea of people. And I was about to pull a Janet and I was like, oh God. And luckily,
damn it.
And I had multiple layers on, but I had on like a wrap top. And the more, it was a really powerful song that I was dancing to. So the more that I started to move, the more it started to come off. And I was like, oh God, oh God, oh God. So I literally was like, yeah, yeah, I'm getting it. And then I was like, I flipped my hair around because I was like, just as it was about to come all the way down. And I was crouched down on the ground, like with my hand, trying to one-handed like tie the rest of it to the back of my strap or whatever, and there are just cameras like everywhere, and I'm just waiting for the internet to be like, Amphi Fest, the nip slip, you know, like, oh my God, it was mortifying. And luckily, surprisingly, I don't think anybody noticed.
Really?
I'm sure they will now if they go and look for
right. If they see this video, they're gonna be like, what? I say that and I didn't even remember it. Oh my gosh.
That was really, really, really bad, and I'm just glad that nothing fell out.
So, as any entertainer and everything, like myself and so many others and everything, have you had a moment where you're like, yes, this is what I'm supposed to be doing? Like, you felt absolutely proud of yourself. Like, that, it was that moment where it was like, I feel like I have achieved my goal of entertainment.
I think that when I did the band that I danced for, I met a lot of the people. I was in the street team, like I helped promote them for many, many years beforehand. And one of the things that we did each year is we all did this parade at a convention called Dragon Con. It has like 50,000 people a year. It's kind of like Comic-Con, but not just about comics and movies, but about everything, costuming and whatever else. And I was really great friends with those people, and I was really excited to dance for them at Dragon Con, because when I, even though I was having like one of the worst weekends that I think I've ever had, they were like, you used to be us and now you're them. You have, we're so proud of you. We love you. Like, we know how hard you worked. And it was just like, even though I was hurting and I may have misstepped or whatever, just to see their faces, and especially like when I got announced, and to hear how excited they were to see one of them have achieved like a goal, like that was one of the most perfect moments, I think. It was really beautiful, because there was points where like I got injured really bad on tour and I didn't know, and I couldn't even stand up. If I went all the way down trying to stand back up again, like on my very last show, it was bad. And having to be able to dance right after that, having gone through international flights and having all these people be like, oh my God, we're so happy for you. I was like, ooh, like so many explosions of gothic glitter, neutral colored rainbows just shot out. Dark rainbows. Yes.
Rainbow.
But yeah, that was really perfect for me. I've danced in front of a lot of people in a lot of places around the world, but to see like those core people who were like my family, that was like, So
something that probably a lot of my viewers and stuff that are actually wanting to get to know you and everything may want to know and everything, what is like your inspiration, or like whenever it comes to like outfits and like makeup styles and like your routine on stage, like what is like, you know, musician, actress, whatever, like what inspires you?
I'm a huge fan of the concept piece, and like I always rant about my Akasha, because I don't know if you've seen Queen of the Damned, but Akasha, so I love dance and I'm a belly dancer, and I love vampires and the supernatural and all that. You know, all the things that entails, ghosts and spirits and things we just don't know about.
Now you know why I like her.
And then being able to incorporate that not only into a costume, but to be able to dance as like the progenitor of the vampire race. Oh my God. It was like a lifelong dream. A lifelong dream. I was the Queen of the Damned.
Yeah, well, I had seen you perform, not so much like, would I say impersonation, or like, as like an interpretation of like Queen of the Damned, but not like, would it be an impersonation that you do, or is it like an interpretation of the character?
I think that particular piece is kind of an interpretation. I actually, and this is kind of weird, but I actually got asked one time, why didn't I go with dark skin, and I was like, Aaliyah in the movie is not only, I mean, she's gorgeous anyway, but it, like in the books, Akasha has white skin and she still has the long black hair, but she's extremely pale. You know, she's the progenitor of the vampire race. But they went with Aaliyah based on her talent and her beauty, which to me was fine because she was exuding that character. So for the Akasha piece, for me, like I feel like it's an interpretation of the movie base of that character, just without doing my skin, because in the movie she is, or in the book she's a little bit different. But when it comes to like a lot of times, like I think one of the first times we ever did a show, I danced in my rubber, like I have this really this cool like woven rubber top and long draping rubber belly dance skirt, and that's just me. Like that's just me. That's how I like to dress and the way that I like to look. But I always have like in each of the pieces I do a song, like if it tells a story or represents a certain emotion, I will try to exude that emotion. So I do a lot of improv and choreography, but Akasha is actually really cool because it's like blends the line of cosplay and dance. So I still get to dance and be myself, but I'm also a character. So there's that. And my hat was made of a salad bowl.
The salad bowl?
My crown was made of a salad bowl.
I did not even know that. That's cool. Yeah. I didn't even know that like the main character from the movie was actually...
Yeah, in the book she's very pale. She's white. But they changed a lot of stuff from the books to the movie, and that's...
Isn't that how it always goes in movies? Like, they always change something about a character, or like, the setting and stuff?
And book people got really angry. But I'm like, you're trying to take this much of a book and smush it into an hour and a half? It's like Harry Potter. how many of those movies did they make? Like, 7? Like, they still didn't even barely touch Harry Potter because there was so much stuff in it. So,
like, you've obviously told me that you've done interviews and everything with, like, musicians and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Out of all the people that you've ever interviewed, which one was your most favorite?
Oh, I would have to say there are two bands in particular, and one of them is kind of obscure, but one of my favorite people to interview was the Ghosts Project. And I have to say it really slow because I always say Ghost Projects or something wrong, but it's the Ghosts Project. And it's a drummer and a violinist who are really good friends of mine. And they do cool, like, jam band stuff, but they are just really fun, like, awesome, earthy people. And I know that you know what it's like to be in the industry and be around a lot of A-type personalities. And for me, doing a lot of band interviews, you always have the A-type, you know, lead singer, or people who are just really, they're not into their art anymore. Like, they're shallow, or they're rude, or they're considering, you know, oh, well, you're interviewing me, and this is, you know, this is something that I'm doing for you, and it's going to be good for you. And I'm like, no, that is not, I don't want to be in that kind of situation.
No, it's like, the point of the interview is to help you and your fans understand you and your label more.
I don't like emotionally shallow people, and there's a lot of that in the entertainment industry, and I know that you know what that's like.
Yes.
But the Ghosts Project and Ego-Likeness. Ego-Likeness is probably one of the coolest, most artistic group that I've ever interviewed. Their music is fantastic, and they, you know, the lead musician, he paints, and he's an art teacher, and both of them are really cool people. And even though they're signed with, like, they've been signed with Metropolis Records, they will totally sit down with anybody and say, yes, let's talk about stuff. And, you know, you just, I don't know, they're just really chill, cool people that I like. And Donna, the lead singer, is hot, and she has really blonde hair. So
my other question for you is probably a lot of people are thinking, oh my God, her eyes. So what is your reason for wearing, as basically Manson, the contacts?
So when I first started doing cosplay and dance, I was trying to find out, I was like, who am I? Like, that was really important to me. Who am I as a person? What kind of emotion do I want to exude? And there were a lot of people out there that wanted me to be something I was. They wanted me to be bubbly. They wanted me to be smiling. They wanted me to be fake. When I danced for years, they have what they call competition face, where you just do this all the time. And you go out on stage and you dance and you're covered in glitter and you're like, yay, I'm dancing to Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairies.
I was in that play called The Nutcracker.
Mm-hmm. I was in that play too.
I was a mouse.
Squeak, squeak. What? Yeah. Were you really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God. I had to do Waltz of the Flowers so many times. Like, I feel like that's my Clockwork Orange. You know how? Have you seen that movie?
Mm-hmm.
This guy goes crazy and they, like, brainwash him. So every time they play Beethoven, he, like, kills everyone. And I feel like Waltz of the Flowers and Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairies, that's my that's my murder everyone song.
Sounds like some people I know.
But I felt like the eyes and the aesthetic So the aesthetic for the contacts for me was to kind of, like, I've always been into, like, ghosts and spectral things, and the way that people treat me sometimes, like, one of the things that made me, like, cement my whole specter thing was every time people would get into the elevator at work, even though I'm 6'1" and really broad shouldered, like, if I was in the corner, I would always scare people. Like, every time the doors would open or they come around the corner, they go and that was kind of what I wanted from my eyes. My eyes are naturally pretty dark, and I tried different things out, but this particular aesthetic gave me, like, that reaction that I wanted from people.
Yeah, because whenever I see these eyes, that's what reminds me of, like, Susie Spector.
Yeah, it's all about this.
Yeah. But anyways, guys, sadly, my camera is dying. And but this right here is the end of the interview and everything. I really hope that you guys enjoyed the last couple of videos and everything that I've done with Susie. Please check out all of her stuff down in the link in description. Of course, you guys already know everything about me and everything, and there will be a video every single Monday.
Everything about
No, they don't know everything about me. They don't know everything about me. However,
that's okay.
There's going to be plenty of time to find out all that stuff, darling, let me tell you. anyways, I love you guys. I'll see you later. And this is Susie.
Bye. It's nice to meet you. Bye.